Hey, welcome back to the channel. I know I'm a bit late for the video for this week, but I also built a product. Today I'm launching a product I've been working on for the last couple of weeks. And I wanted to show you my thought process and the steps I took to bring the product to life. So let's start with the idea. I wanted to build a product where you can create a professional headshot of yourself for your LinkedIn profile and your resume. This is actually nothing new. There are already products out there that are doing something very similar. A lot of them are not really good, and you can already tell from the website that the result of the headshot is not looking that great. But there are also good ones like Headshot Pro and Aragon AI. They did a really good job on the headshots. So why did I decide to build the same thing? There are two reasons. First of all, it fits very well with the products I already built, like Resume and the LinkedIn review. So what I'm trying to do is build an ecosystem that has all the tools you need to land a new job. And a professional headshot aligns very well with the other tools. And the second reason is I saw an opportunity to build a better product. So I tried out two of the products and the results were kind of, okay-ish, but the resemblance was not really there. I mean, yes, it looks similar, but still not good enough for me to put on my resume or LinkedIn profile. So sometimes it's just about making the UI simpler for the end user or a similar product but for another target group. So here we are creating a product to generate AI headshots for your resume and LinkedIn profile. Of course, building the product means we need to get familiar with the tools and the space. That took actually most of the time doing research, understanding how things work and how we can do something better and something different. It took me like 2 months to figure out how things work and to try out different settings. But the time was needed and now I got something really solid where the result is pretty good. As long as you can solve a pain point, you can get a customer. You want to have a name that fits your product. You want to have a name that is easy to spell and also ranks well on Google. And you want a name that is still available as a domain. So here's what I typically do. I go over to Google Trends and try to figure out some search terms people might look for. So I try out things like resume picture or CV photo and I focus on the European and US market. I also go over to Google and just type in the search term to check what the suggestions look like. And this actually aligns pretty well with what I found on Google Trends. So let's head over to Namecheap to check if the domain is still available. And oh my god, the name resume photo was still available. So I had to get this. This is so lucky, I can't believe it. This should make a lot of things easier. And hopefully also to get organic traffic in the future. You know, most product names don't work out because the domain has already been bought in, I don't know, 1994. Crazy, I'm really, really happy with this one. Right, let's move on. Over the years, I have created a starter pack for one-pagers. So I basically copy everything over and adjust the copy. But this time I wanted to put in a little bit more effort. I also wanted to highlight the outcome of the images in a cool way. And for this, I went to one of my favorite places to get some inspiration, CodeDrops. Most of the examples are a bit too fancy and too crazy, but I found two cool effects which I recreated on the webpage. The first one is this movement of the images while you scroll. And the other one is a before and after effect. I wanted to highlight the difference between the selfies you have put in for the training of the AI and the outcome, which is the professional headshot. And I know I built the website on my own and also did the design, but you don't have to. There are a lot of cool tools out there to create a great looking website. I also use website builders for some products because they got really, really good and it makes things way easier and faster. Okay, I'm kind of lazy when it comes to logos. Sure, they can look great and have a huge impact on your corporate identity, but I'm not corporate. I want to solve a pain point customers have, and I don't think customers do care that much about a fancy logo. So what I'd like to do is to go over to an icon library, which is open source, and pick a nice icon and use it as the logo. I went over to Phosphor, which is an icon library I recently came across, and searched for camera and found this nice little aperture icon. Let's copy it over to Figma, add a black background to it, and yeah, looks good. So for the font, I usually pick one I already have used in the past. But for you guys, I went out and tried to find a new one. Google has some great fonts, GitHub and Verso also dropped some nice fonts, but I came across this one and fell in love. Just need to make sure it's open source and we are allowed to use it. But looks good, so let's keep going. For analytics, I use Plausible. It's a very simple analytics tool, but it does everything I need. And most importantly, it is GDPR compliant, which means I don't need to add a cookie notice, which is great because I hate those things. It also helps me to figure out the search terms people are using, traffic spikes, and check the overall performance over time. If you want to get attention on your product, you have to share it as many times as you can without sounding like spam. So I always try to add some kind of value in my post, either show a unique UI, how I was able to figure out a problem, or just in general some kind of progress you made in the product. So I will share a resume photo on LinkedIn, on X, on Instagram, and of course here on YouTube. And I will also post this on Hacker News and Product Hunt. Even if your product is not ranking high or doesn't get a lot of attention on those websites, you get a really good backlink to your website, which helps to rank higher on Google. I will also share it on my newsletters and my other products. So basically everywhere I can. And for the long run, I might offer this to career coaches and for their clients. And hopefully I will rank well on Google for the search term resume photo to get organic traffic over time. So let's check out the final product. The structure is very similar to my resume checker, which I covered in my last video. It took a lot of time to build this product and I'm really happy with the outcome. I always like to show the difference between what you have right now and the difference between what you can get from the tool. And in our case, it's basically you have a few selfies of yourself and you can get a professional headshot in roughly an hour. And then a clear benefit like putting it on your LinkedIn profile or on your resume can have this kind of positive impact. This is also the first time I did one of these bento grids. I'm really happy with the outcome. I think the generated images look really good compared to other platforms and the resemblance is also pretty high. I'm a little bit nervous how the product will perform, but I will keep you posted. I think in the next video or maybe the video after that, I will show how it went. I hope this video gave you some insight into the process of launching a product. So Resume Photo AI is now live. You can use the product to create professional headshots for your LinkedIn profile or your resume. And if you have watched so far, I also got a discount code for you in the description below. The first 100 people will get 50% off. So for just 10 bucks, you can get your professional headshot. That's it from my side. I hope this video gave you some insights into the process of launching a product. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel to get more content like this. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.